We have a motto at Collingwood: not only side by side we stick together, but unless you stand for something, you stand for nothing. And the thing we stand for at Collingwood is we don't forget the people who made our club. The people from working class Collingwood, as I said, in the slums, fighting against no hope in their lives to be able to come up with a glimmer. And Collingwood became that glimmer for over 100 years now.
What you see at the Collingwood Football Club is action, putting their culture into practice in their wider community. And I think that is a remarkable testament to the leadership of Gary Peart, of David Emerson, and in particular of the wonderful Eddie McGuire. We've got an amazing team based here that actually back those guys up. So we have a place here, the Hamodava Cafe, where people are able to come and get a good meal, a nutritious meal. They're able to access a full-time lawyer. They're able to work with a full-time psychologist and an alcohol and drugs worker as well. And they're able to get all of the supports that they need to help get themselves back on their feet.
Ladies and gentlemen, we open the Magpie Nest here in the city, Hamodava Cafe.
I see the work the club does with homeless people, and it's a real testament to the club's ethos and culture that this is a part of what the club sees as its mission.
Sometimes you have a premiership year, sometimes you don't make the finals like we did this year, but there's things in a football club that we have to be proud of, and this is something that I'm very proud of as a Collingwood person, and I hope that everyone who's involved and every member who says, what are we doing with our money? Well, this is what we're doing with the money as well.
Basically, when we started here, we kept finding homeless people that had nowhere to stay, and the frustration was we had workers to care for them but nowhere to put them to get them off the streets. So Magpie Nest has been not just an opportunity to have housing for homeless people, but they're living in beautiful houses, and they're living in houses that are really wonderfully furnished. But it's also sent a powerful message to people that are often forgotten and invisible that even the Collingwood Football Club is thinking about them and that they count.